Hi, I'm Dan Handelman with Portland Cop Watch and Peace and Justice working. I'm going to take a little moment of organizer's prerogative. Organizer's prerogative, I'm going to ask the audience a question. How did you hear about tonight's event? How many people heard about it from an email from a co-sponsor? That's kind of quite a few. How many heard about it over social media? That's also quite a few. How many heard about it from KBOO? Just a few. And how many heard about it on OPD? And how many people heard about it at their places, like word of mouth or something? Okay. That's very helpful to us in the future for organizing. So my real question is, Mike German is not listening to all the speakers. So my question was, you mentioned San Francisco. I was running around a lot, so I don't know if you went into depth, but I was hoping to talk more about how they got out. That happened last February, which is right. Very recent.
So in San Francisco, I want to say it was 2012. My years might be off. A lot happened in 2012. There was an effort based on the 2011 ordinance here that California has a state law similar to the Oregon law that says they need reasonable suspicion before they can gather criminal intelligence. They have a long history in San Francisco of the Red Squads going out and investigating people because of their political activity. So they had these strong rules, and that question came up later that Portland can create this ordinance to regulate the activity and to get transparency. We should have it too. So San Francisco passed an ordinance that was very similar in that it didn't really limit activities so much as just ask for transparency. We want to know how these officers on the task force are being used, what kind of cases they're being used, whether they're being used in this assessment sort of category where they're not complying with their own state law. And similar to what happened here, the law enforcement officers, including the state locals that were participating, were reluctant to share that information with the public and weren't providing the kind of reports that were required. So when there was finally push came to shove, show us the report, they said, we'll just pull out. And they withdrew in February. And San Francisco is still around. Again, there's a lot of fear-mongering around this, but investigating innocent people doesn't help find guilty people. It's not an issue. There are law enforcement has a lot of authority. They should focus that where people are actually being harmed, not where somebody thinks somebody in the future might somehow be a threat.
Hi, my name is Philip J. Wolf, and I'm running for City Council position number 2. And I wanted to share with the group my very strong concern with the JTTF and the fact that it's a very public abuse. It's been very clear. Going all the way down to the lower levels, which means it's impossible to, obviously we can't start at the federal level, we need to start at the local level with the city commission. And my question about the JTTF, I'm wondering if they are in fact not engaged with them anymore, what does the mayor and the police commission, what would their role be? How would we figure out, or what can PPP do if a terrorist attack does happen in Portland? What would the process look like assuming JTTF is not involved? Do they have a process already in place, or is there no process? Can you explain or expand on what that would look like?
Sure. So federal, state, and local governments all work together in a variety of capacities, and particularly on law enforcement, there is that kind of sharing on a regular basis, right? There's all kinds of reporting from state and local on crime data that the FBI uses when the FBI has an inspection done. So headquarters supervisors come out to evaluate the local FBI office. They'll go first to the Portland police chief and say, how's the local FBI doing, right? So there is this routine interaction and cooperation that is nothing surprising about. essential necessity to
almost.
The task force creates a situation where it basically co-opts local law enforcement. It actually makes them, as Kimberly suggested, deputized federal officers. And in giving them a clearance, creates a wall between them and their supervisors, which is not, it's great for the FBI. And I remember talking to one police chief shortly after 9/11, and he said, you know, I thought, yeah, it's important for us to get involved in the JTTF, and we put two police officers on it, and they came back to me and said they couldn't tell me what they were doing, and I thought, okay, I just lost two officers, and I'm gaining nothing because nobody's telling me what's going on. There is local cooperation that can happen without the Joint Terrorism Task Force, and the problems that the Joint Terrorism Task Force brings, particularly when you have a state law, right? The idea that we have state and local officials working in a capacity where they are violating state law undermines law, right? That undermines the rule of law. You can't have police officers operating in an environment where they can ignore the law. So I would argue that the way the situation works now, with the lack of oversight, the lack of guidance, the lack of strong rules to prevent abuse, more harm is done by working through the Joint Terrorism Task Force than will be done working through regular cooperation that occurs in all sorts of other cases.
Thank you. Thank you so much. One just follow-up question. So basically, you're saying that because the JTTF is not following the rule of law, taking advantage of these lack of oversight, lack of transparency, everything you mentioned, if we are not involved with the JTTF, then Portland would be considered a sanctuary city? Is that right?
Yeah, do you want to speak to that a little bit?
A sanctuary city, is that correct?
Already are a sanctuary city, and thanks to a 30-year-old sanctuary law, which really prevents local law enforcement from trying to enforce federal law.
Yeah, and so I guess I would just add to that is I think that it does undermine our sanctuary state and our sanctuary city status for Portland to be part of the JTTF. Because ICE is a member of the JTTF, and you know, granted, there's things ICE are doing that we don't agree with, and when we say we're not going to be collaborating with ICE, and yet then there's this sort of secrecy, and we don't know what's happening. I think it undermines the public's ability to believe in our sanctuary state and city laws. So I think I'm going to go ahead and wrap up. I know we did lose a few people in the audience since we ran a bit long, but I just appreciate everybody coming out, and those of you who were willing to stay with us to the very end. I'm sorry for the few folks who wrote questions that we didn't get to, but really thank you.